The Irregulars is available to stream on Netflix UK and Ireland now, but if, like us, you've already mainlined all 8 episodes, you're probably still mulling over that shock ending and what might happen next. You're not the only one. Here are 6 of the most Googled questions about this show. One. Who stars in The Irregulars? The Irregulars has a hugely talented cast made up of new and familiar faces. Let's break it down a little. Heading it up is 24-year-old Tadia Graham as B, the no-nonsense leader of the gang. Graham is a relative newcomer. Although she's had big roles in shows like Curfew and Us, this is by far her biggest profile gig to date. She's backed up by Darcy Shaw as B's sister Jessie, Jojo McCary as Billy, who you might recognise from Sex Education and Cursed, and Mikhail David as wisecracking Spike. His first screen role was in the first ever episode of Black Mirror, It's Just 14. The gang also gets a new recruit in the form of Harrison Osterfield as a mysterious posh boy named Leo, secretly Prince Leopold. Taking on the iconic roles of Sherlock Holmes and Dr. Watson are Henry Lloyd Hughes, who you may have seen in Killing Eve and The Inbetweeners, and Royce Pearson from Line of Duty and The Witcher. Alice is played by Eileen O'Higgins. Also appearing in Season 1 are Rory McCann, aka the Hound from Game of Thrones as the Birdmaster, and Edward Hogg from Pennyworth as Leo's weaselly footman, Daimler. The evil mastermind behind everything is Clark Peters as the sinister and apparently nameless Linen Man. You may have seen him in shows like Marvel's Jessica Jones, The Wire, and his Dark Materials. 2. Is The Irregulars based on a book? The answer to this is a little bit complicated. Basically yes, but also no. The characters of Sherlock Holmes and John Watson were of course created by Sir Arthur Conan Doyle in 1887, first appearing in his novel A Study in Scarlet. That book quickly establishes the genius detective with a drug habit, his stalwart sidekick Watson, and their shared home and workplace, 221B Baker Street in London. The book also featured the Baker Street Irregulars, a gang of street urchins that Holmes uses as spies throughout London. But the gang have changed quite a bit for the TV show, mind. In the books, they're all boys and they appear in a mere 3 stories, A Study in Scarlet, The Sign of the Four, and The Adventure of the Crooked Man. So while The Irregulars definitely has its origins in Conan Doyle's work, the characters and stories are entirely new, invented by showrunner Tim Bidwell. 3. Was there a real-life Prince Leopold? Leo, played by Harrison Osterfield, is one of the most intriguing characters in the show. A handsome young prince with a secret. At home, he is Prince Leopold, the son of Queen Victoria. He leads a lonely life of seclusion forced on him by illness, with only his footman Daimler for company. He's much happier on the streets getting into adventures with the Irregulars and trying to cop off with B at every opportunity. But was he, in fact, based on a real person? This is an easy one to answer. Yes, there really was a Prince Leopold, and yes, he genuinely suffered from haemophilia, a rare blood condition that made him especially susceptible to injury. Tragically, it would be the cause of his death aged just 30 after he fell and suffered a blow to the head. As far as we know, however, the real Leopold never went on any crime-fighting capers in the streets of London. Then again, perhaps Queen Victoria hushed it all up. 4. Who does B end up with? One of the main tensions in Season 1 of The Irregulars is the love triangle between heroic B, buff young bruiser Billy, and shy Leo. At the start of the series, there's clearly a growing romantic tension between B and Billy, but then Leo rocks up wearing that fabulous blue jacket and B is instantly smitten. Although she's wary of this new member of the gang at first, it's not long before they share their first kiss, breaking Billy's heart. Over the course of the season, the relationship between Leo and B blossoms, but he can't keep his double life secret forever, and B is furious when Daimler tells her the truth about Leo's royal heritage. Of course, their falling out doesn't last, and by the end of the season they've patched things up, but is it too little, too late? Leo has been set up to marry someone far more suitable in the eyes of the crown, Helena Augusta. The season ends with B and Leo saying their goodbyes, perhaps forever. Now, no one really believes that. Maybe we'll see Leo cross paths with his old flame again, but the history books say that the real Prince Leopold married Helena Augusta, so perhaps Billy is still in with the shot after all. 5. Does Sherlock die in The Irregulars? At the end of Season 1, Sherlock, played by Henry Lloyd Hughes, vanishes into the Rip to be with his lost love, Alice. Although Watson tries desperately to stop him, the great detective is pulled through, seemingly never to be seen again. It's a devastating note to end the first season on. Will this be the last we see of the great detective? 6. What does the linen man want? Although he initially appears to be a friend to Jesse, the mysterious linen man is eventually revealed to be a diabolical mastermind, intent on opening the rib no matter the consequences. But what does he want? Jesse meets him in the first episode, where he appears to her in a psychic vision. He tells her how she can use her growing powers to read the minds of others. Later, he tells Jesse about the rip and cunningly manipulates her into seeking it out. We also learn that, like Jesse, he too is an ipsissimus, a powerful psychic. He says that he's coming to London to help her close the rip forever. When he arrives, however, he reveals his true plan, to absorb the powers from the other side of the rip and become all-powerful. He also, rather creepily, wants Jesse to have children with his son so that he can breed a race of powerful ipsissimuses. Or is it ipsissimi? We need Leo to explain collective nouns to us again.
Unkindness is the collective noun. A collective noun is...
What a collective noun is.
Of course.
Do you have any unanswered questions about the irregulars? Or do you know the correct pluralization of ipsissimus? Let us know in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe to Netflix UK for more features about your favourite movies,